The Honourable Member from Courtenay-Alberni.
Speaker, I find it pretty rich when Conservatives start talking about expanding pharmacare when they're doing everything they can to block it, Mr. Speaker. 3 years ago, they voted against pharmacare. They could have brought forward amendments to include an expanding that would cover people with rare diseases. They didn't do that. In fact, they're saying that people are already covered. I'll tell you about Becky in my riding. She cites our out-of-pocket costs for my son's insulin and devices came to just over $11,000 per year. It's so expensive, sometimes the pharmacy calls me to give me a heads up about how much an order will be, as if we have an option. Without it, he will die. So something like National Pharmacare would be a game changer for us. So through you, Mr. Speaker, maybe my colleague can talk about, would she be willing to work with the NDP and the Conservatives if everybody came together and wanted to include rare diseases? Because you know there's a willing partner right here.
The Honourable Member from Davenport.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I want to thank the Honourable Member for his question. I want to also thank him for his commitment and his passion to the National Pharmacare Program. I'll say to you, in my riding of Davenport, having a National Pharmacare Program is very popular. They're very excited with Phase 1 and the introduction of diabetes medication being covered as well as contraceptives. And so I know that they're looking for an expansion of this program, and I know that's something I'm very interested in as well. Thank you.